we are going to continue with the chapter in the Kingdom of Peace. Yesterday there was a lot of disturbance in the network, so we'll be starting this chapter right from beginning. In the Kingdom of Peace, it is believed that fools are so dangerous that it is believed that fools are just a man. So it is believed that fools are so dangerous that only very wise people can manage them. Who are the fools in the story? So what happens to them? So who are the fools in the story? The authorities are termed as the fools. But do you think it's only the authorities who are the fools? Can you say that it is only the authorities who are the fools, or somebody else also? Yes, you can raise hand and tell me. Do you think it's only the authorities who are the fools? Yes, Diya Handa, raise hand. Yes.
Ma'am, we cannot only term the authorities as fools. The population of the kingdom is to be considered as fools, as they are following those orders, and following those orders, and then in the fear of death, they are not saying anything against it.
Yes. Yes, very well done, Didiya. Very good answer. It's not the authorities who can be termed as fools. Even the people, those who follow the ones who are foolish, they are equally foolish. Okay, so when the authorities are not doing the things as per the requirement or as per the ethics, then it becomes a responsibility of the subjects, that is the people, to set the authorities. Right, but yes, it is also very important, like whether the decision, whether this very decision, whether who is the foolish one, it is to be considered by only the wise person. It needs wisdom. It's only a wise person who can make out whether the things are all right or not. So, okay, in the Kingdom of Fools, this one page we had read out yesterday, and what we read out, like in that Kingdom of Fools, the king and the ministers, you know, they were idiots. So they wanted to do everything in an extraordinary manner. They wanted like everything they do should not be something common. So in order to pursue their dream of doing something uncommon, they told their people to sleep in the morning and to work at night. So as a result, the whole place, this whole kingdom, you know, throughout the day, the kingdom would be quiet. It would be still because everyone would be sleeping. And as our night would be drawing nearer, the place would become full of activity. And the night would be full of activity. All the business would run. So everything would happen only at night. So the things were going on. Nobody protested. Everybody followed king's orders because everybody wanted to save one's life. And once a saint and his disciple, they came there. A guru and a disciple came to this place. And when they, in the very morning, the whole day, when they did not see anyone moving about, but at night the place was, a hub of activity, they were surprised. But anyway, they purchased the groceries and all. And another surprising thing which they met was that whatever they purchased, that costed them only 1 rupee. So that was again very surprising. Though they could have been also happier like other people when you get something so cheap. Imagine you all start getting everything at ₹1. Everything. So what will happen? Of course, many of the people would be very happy. This is what happens in our country also. okay, when people are told that electricity is free or water supply will be free, nothing, you won't have to pay for anything, then people are also very happy. So no road tax, no toll tax, no toll plazas and all. People are very happy because this is what people always want. When they don't have to spend money, when they don't have to take out money from their pockets, they are blessed, and they, you know, support that kind of authority, the one who makes them or provide them the things free of cost. So it is the foolishness of the authority to make such promises that the things would be cheaper or free of cost. And the public who expects these kinds of cheap things, they also don't mind going in for cheap authorities also, right? So it is up to the public what kind of government they want, okay? And let's see. So here these people, guru and disciple, when they found guru, when he saw that the things were free of cost, then he was upset. And he decided like they would not be supporting that kind of king, because he was giving the things so free of cost. And secondly, the kind of system which he had promoted in the place, that was not something which was ethical. Ethically, if you talk about the values, we must wake up early in the morning, then we must do the things, and the night is meant to sleep, okay? And that is a system set by God. So, but, and Guru, he wanted to challenge this. Let's see now. So I'm starting from here, third paragraph. When they had cooked and eaten, the Guru realized that this was a kingdom of fools and it wouldn't be a good idea for them to stay there. So the Guru decided that he concluded that it was a place of fools and they should not stay there for a longer time. This is no place for us. Let's go, he said to his disciple. But the disciple didn't want to leave the place. Everything was cheap here. All he wanted was good, cheap food, the Guru said. All he wanted was good and cheap food, the Guru said. They are all fools. This won't last very long. And you can't tell what they'll do to you next. So Guru was a far-sighted person. What happened? Like the disciple, he said, like everything is so good and everything is cheap. So what one wants, if you're getting everything, if you're getting the best things at such cheap rates, then why to go away from that place? Then Guru said, like, when it is happening, then you never know what this kind of government will do with you tomorrow. Okay? This won't last very long. What won't last very long? What won't last very long? Raise hand. What won't last very long? Raise hand if you know the answer. What won't last very long? What won't last very long? Raise hand if you know the answer. Come on. Am I audible, children? Is my voice clear? Am I audible, Ramneek? Ramneek, am I audible? Okay, okay, Lavleen. Thank you, Lavleen, beta. Okay, show gesture immediately. Whatever the answer is. If no, then I can mend it. Okay, okay. So my point, I was asking you people one question, like what won't last very long? So what won't last very long? Like this system won't last very long. What system? This system where the government is giving the people the things at free of cost or maybe at cheaper rates. This system doesn't last very long. When the economy will run short of funds, then that kind of government has no stake to take on. Okay, then this government can get toppled, or then this government, what this government will do with the people, you never know. So the best government is the one who collects the revenue as per the requirement and gives the subsidies to the requisite class, to the required class. Okay, when the rich people, when the rich class is asked to give the, from the rich class, when the government is taking the money as per the requirement and is distributing that money collected to the poor class or to the needy or to the sectors where the money is to be invested. For example, health care system. For example, the defense system, health care system, or you can say other infrastructure, making of roads and all. Okay, going in for the new trains, going in for the new things which are required for the development of a country. So the fund is to be collected for the betterment of the nation. The fund is not to be collected to exploit the rich class. Okay, so collection of the fund is important and should be done, and we people should support that government. And this is what Guru is saying. Guru is the wise person of the story. And he says, and nowadays, if somebody speaks up like this in this country, then that person is termed as a stupid person. So it is also very important that we see who the wise person is. Wise person is not the one who supports a stupid government. Okay, if somebody says that we want free, we'll be giving you free this or that, and we won't consider him or her a wise authority. Or the people who say, wow, that person is giving us free this or that, even that follower is not wise. Wisdom lies in going in for the welfare of your country, nothing else. Right? Country comes first. We all comes later on. So this is what Guru is saying. Guru says that this won't last very long. This system of giving free things or cheap things to the people will not last very long. Sooner or later, this system will collapse. And when there will be shortage of funds, then those people, then those authorities and those kings, what they will do with the people, you never know. You can't tell what they'll do to you next. But the disciple won't listen to the guru's wisdom. He wanted to save the guru. He wanted to stay. The guru finally gave up and said, do what you want. I am going, and left. The disciple stayed on, ate his fill every day, bananas and ghee and rice and wheat, and grew fat like a street side sacred bull. So what happened? The guru, who was a wise person, he could see like what would happen tomorrow. He could see because he was far-sighted man. So he left the place and the disciple stayed there. He kept on enjoying the free, foods, free fruit, free everything. And eventually he became fat like a street side sacred bull. Okay. So here it is a humorous comparison that person became fat like a sacred bull, street side sacred bull. So that bull, the one who is of no use, street side sacred bulls, they are of no use. Okay, the bull, when it is there with the farmer and is doing work, it is considered sacred. But when it becomes a street side bull, then no one bothers to, fend him properly then. So one bright day, a thief broke into a rich merchant's house. He had made a hole in the wall and sneaked in. So what happened? On a bright day, a thief broke into a rich merchant's house. He had made a hole in the wall and sneaked in. So as he was carrying out his loot, what is loot? Plunder. So whatever he had taken away from that house, the wall of the old house collapsed on his head and killed him on the spot. So that thief, died on the spot because the wall from where he was going to run off, that wall collapsed and he died on the spot. His brother ran to the king and complained. Your Highness, when my brother was pursuing his ancient trade, a wall fell on him and killed him. This merchant is to blame. He should have built a good, strong wall. You must punish the wrongdoer and compensate the family for his injustice. So, children, I guess many of you might be able to relate this story with what is happening in our society as well. So, what is happening in the story? Once a thief came to a merchant's house, of course, for stealing. After taken the whole, you know, thing, whatever he wanted to steal, when he made, he carried all that, you know, loot. He wanted to run off through a wall, but that wall collapsed. And there he died because of that, you know, accident. So the brother of that thief knocked the door off court. He came to the court, or you can say, who is the court over here? King himself. So he came to the king and complained. So the brother of the thief, he is complaining that the merchant should be punished because he did not make a strong wall. Because of that weak wall, his brother died because when he was doing his old business. This is what is happening nowadays. Those who are doing illegal things, those who want to do something wrong to the government or the authorities, they are all joining hands to prove that whatever wrong is going on, that is right. So here, thief, does the brother of a thief have any right to go to court? He has no right because the thief was going in for illegal activity. But when he died, what happened? There are some people, those who gain sympathy on one or the other ground and try to befool the system. The king said, justice will be done. Don't worry. And at once summoned the owner of the house. So first of all, tell me, was that thief killed by somebody? Was that thief killed by somebody? So you people are saying no. The thief was not killed by anyone. Who killed the thief? Who killed the thief? How did the thief die? You can answer me this. Okay. Who killed the thief or... So Arshdeep Kaur of 9C says that wall or his own head. Wall killed him, or did the wall come and kill him? The wall was weak. Okay, it might have been on the verge of collapsing, and the moment he might have stepped on it, he died. The wall collapsed and he died. But my question is, who is responsible for the death of the thief? Who is responsible for the death of the thief? He himself. Yes, Dia. Yes. So don't say destiny. He himself. He killed himself. The thief killed himself. If he had not tried to climb up the wall, then the wall might not have collapsed and he might not have died. If he had not gone into stealing purpose, if he had not climbed up the wall, if the wall might not have become weak, he might not have died. So the thief died because of his own mistake. Who told him to go there? Who told him to climb up the wall? But this is what is happening in our system also. So when people go into, when people are going in for, against the system, then some mishap happens. They want the government to apologize for that mistake, which they have done. So the king said, justice will be done. Don't worry. And at once summoned the owner of the house. So this is what the system is also there. When the criminals, you know, when the wrongdoers die of their own mistake, then the authorities, so-called authorities, they come up and sympathize with them to attract the voters, nothing else. Right? Children, the internet connection is getting a little unstable. That's why my voice might be cracking in between. So connection is unstable. When the merchant arrived, the king questioned him. What's your name? Such and such, your highness. Were you at home when the dead man burgled your house? So the king questioned the merchant now. See, the person who has nothing to do with the crime, the person who has nothing to do with the with that act of killing the thief, that person is also questioned. So, were you at home when the dead man burgled your house? Yes, my lord. He broke in and the wall was weak. It fell on him. The accused pleads guilty. Your wall killed this man's brother. You have murdered a man. We have to punish you. Lord, said the helpless merchant, I didn't put up the wall. It's really the fault of the man who built the wall. He didn't build it right. You should punish him. So now when the merchant saw that the king was going to punish him, he said, sir, it's not my fault. The fault is of the person who built the wall. So he should be brought in and he should be punished. So then king said, who is that? My lord, the wall was built in my father's time. I know the man. He's an old man now. He lives nearby. The king sent out messengers to bring in the bricklayer who had built the wall. They brought him tied hand and foot. So the king, you know, called that, sent his messengers and asked that man to bring that bricklayer who had made the wall about many years ago. So you there, did you build this man's wall in his father's time? Yes, my lord, I did. What kind of wall is this that you built? It has fallen on a poor man and killed him. You have murdered him. We have to punish you by death. So see king's words. The king is telling that innocent mason, the bricklayer, that you built a very weak wall about hundreds of years ago. The wall which could survive hundreds of years, that wall, that person is being blamed for making a weak wall because of a thief. So children, what is required? The requirement is like we need to recognize who the thief is. Who the thief is? Is the merchant the criminal, or is the thief really the criminal, or the king is the criminal? Got it? So the point is like those who are joining the wrongdoers, they are also idiots. What kind of so? Before the king could order the execution, the bricklayer pleaded. Now he also requested, please listen to me before you give your orders. It's true that I built this wall and it was no good. But that was because my mind was not on it. I remember very well a dancing girl who was going up and down that street all day with her anklets jingling, and I couldn't keep my eyes on my mind on the wall I was building. You must get that dancing girl. I know where she lives. So this bricklayer got the nerve of the king. He was able to make out that this king has no mind of his own. So whatever you will tell him, he will believe it. So the bricklayer told him, like, sir, it's not my fault. The fault is of that dancing girl who distracted me on the day when I was making the wall. You are right. The case deepens. We must look into it. It's not easy to judge such complicated cases. Let's get the dancer whenever, wherever she is. Now see, so what bricklayer said, the king was taken in by her words also. So he said, okay, it's a very complicated case. So was it really a complicated case? Come on, children, tell me. The king says it was a very complicated case. It's a very complicated case. It will take some time to solve the case. Is the case really complicated? Yes or no? If yes, why? If no, why? Raise hand. Is the case really complicated? Yes, is the case really complicated? Come on, children. Is the case really complicated? Raise hand. Raise hand. I'll be asking you people to speak up. Okay, Gurpal, yes.
No, ma'am. The case is not complicated.
How can you say this?
It is a very simple matter.
Mm-hmm. How can you say
because
this?
No other second person is involved in this case.
Mm-hmm. But how can you say that the case was very simple and the king made it complicated?
Ma'am.
Yes, Panika, you are right.
By making the case complicated, the king proved that he was foolish.
Okay, somebody else? Panika, okay, you are saying that yes, the king made it complicated. This is what I am asking you. But how was the king, how did king make it complicated? The case was of course not complicated. Then how can you say that it was not complicated, Lovelina?
Ma'am, the king was not able to recognize that who was the wrongdoer of this case, and the wrongdoer, obviously the thief, already got punished for his wrong deeds.
Yes.
He was just enlightening the case.
Yes, yes, you are right. So children, you all also know that the wrongdoer in this case was a thief himself. It was a thief who was doing something wrong, and he got the punishment on its own. So there was no need to open up this kind of case. Okay. So when the brother of that thief went to king to plead his case, then at that very time, the king would have asked him like what your brother was and what he was doing at the wall. Why did he jump the wall? What was he doing at merchant's house? So instead of, making the case complicated, he could have first of all made out that the wrongdoer has been punished on his own. So the king only made the case complicated, thereby getting distracted from the issue. Okay, or moreover, you can say in order to listen to somebody else's pleas, the king did not listen to his own conscience, or he did not even consult his own courtmen, or you can say his own lawyers or all. Every kingdom, every court, okay, here kingdom is, he has some people, has some wise people or the lawyers, and he should have consulted them. First of all, king should have enough mind to make out that the thief was killed on his own. But in case he did not have that much of wisdom, he should at least have intelligent ministers with him. And he did not have any of those ministers also with him. Right? Okay, so time is almost over. We can conclude today's lecture. Tomorrow we'll continue, okay? So see you tomorrow. Thank you, children.